seem very happy about the antics here that Murray has. Looks like he's staging some kind of a sit-out here. To do things on his own terms here.
All right, you, girlfriend.
And here we go.
We love this show, my new man.
Offering him some orange soda. I don't think Cage is digging the orange soda.
Kata loves orange soda.
The crowd loves orange soda.
Took it like a man!
Oh, disrespecting the orange soda now.
And there's that first right hand of the match. And he's fighting back. Couple right hands.
Do not disrespect the orange soda.
And there's the counter to the Irish whip and a right hand by Cage. Kata rocking. Pushes Kata into the corner and there's a chop.
That's one of the signature moves of Cage. He has these mean spirited slaps that he will do. The chest and the face of his opponent. He could easily do an elbow, a forearm, or even a fist, but he often chooses to just smack them.
Ooh, pinch him in nipple. That one hurt.
We've already seen orange soda and purple nipples.
It's high school all over again, but Cage back to the offensive with the chop, throwing him in the other corner. Kata with the counter. Rolls out of it. Ooh, reverse arm drag, another one flipping him over twice. For the counter, takes out the leg. Cage face first. He is not liking that.
Kata can move.
Ooh, a boot to the face by Kata. Goes for the pin. Two. He's out at two.
Kata's been impressive in this short little sprint that we've seen so far. He's really taking the fight to Matt Cage. And we know, all antics aside, Matt Cage is no joke.
Ooh, double shot right to the throat. And a European uppercut. Kata goes down.
Please, don't be gentle.
So much for all those antics.
He's so nice.
There's a nice little counter by Kata.
He took his eye off of him for a split second. And they let Kata get a move in.
Oh. Haymaker right to the jaw by Cage. Kata goes down and Cage harassing the crowd a little bit.
And he paid for it right away.
Kata going on the offensive. Ooh, rolling neck breaker. Only a two count. Kata's got to capitalize on this advantage he's got.
I think that Kata might be more of a threat than Cage wanted to believe. The whole orange soda incident at the beginning, I think, threw Cage off.
Kata to the corner, predicting that counter again, and face first into the turnbuckle. Oh, Cage saw that one coming a mile away.
That could cause a concussion, that could damage his neck. His nose could be broken. That was a very simple but very mean move. It completely killed the pace of the match for Kata.
Cage taking a moment to argue with the audience, but he's right back to Kata. Snapper takeover. Plays him down, and ooh, jumping boot steps right on the jaw of Kata.
That's
going
it.
For the pin, one count. Kata's not going down without a fight.
It was a strike right to that same jaw that just ate the bottom turnbuckle.
And he throws him right outside. Kata hitting the ground.
I think we can expect a lot of shots to the head from Cage in this match.
Those right hands are mean.
Yeah.
capitalize. Going to one corner. It's coming at him in the other. Ooh. Big shoulder splash right to the corner. Going again. He's picking up the pace. Cage falling to the ground. And he's going for a third one. Boot right to the face. And a little bit of a shake for Cage. Splash, crushing the face, going for the pin. Two count, Kata can't quite get it.
I have to say, for such a fun-loving guy, he's being way more relentless than I thought he was going to be. So far, he's stayed pretty focused ever since that orange soda got set down.
Cage getting, or Kata getting the crowd going, but Cage with the counter. Two count, he's going for the pin again. And a third time, just repeated two counts.
Now, Cage did not win the match from this, but what he did do, he forced Kata to have to kick out three times. That's three times where all Cage had to do was put his body across Kata's. Meanwhile, Kata had to exert the force to get his shoulder up to not lose the match, not once, not twice, but three times.
Shoulder block right to the stomach, and Cage goes down, but Kata flipping and failing, and Cage all over him, going for the pin again. One, two, and it's just a two count.
He may have kicked out, but again, that took more energy. This is what Cage is doing now. He's splitting the difference. He's taking every little bit of exertion that he can make Kata use to get out of any of these moves. He's draining his energy slowly, and while they're evenly matched, that little bit of extra work that Kata has to do to continue to keep up with him, that's going to catch up, and that's going to make him fall behind Cage. He's going to become fatigued faster than Cage.
Ooh, jawbreaker breaking the crossface that Cage has. Yeah, he's boot to the face. Cage's number one strategy really should be to slow Kata down, because Kata came in with a lot more energy, and you can see it now. Even with the beating he's taken, he's coming back. Cage into the corner. Kata with the clothesline. Man, oh, face plant. Kata getting his momentum going, getting the crowd behind him.
But you can see it.
Ooh, pump handle suplex.
He's in control right now, but you can see it. If you look closely, he's breathing just a little bit harder than he was. He's moving just a little bit slower than he was early in the match. Cage's strategy has not failed so far.
You can also see the fatigue and the frustration on his face after that two count. He just verified with the ref two or three times.
And even right there, he didn't stand straight up. He used the rope to pull himself up. He's figuring out now that he's running lower on energy. He has to conserve whatever he can. And that's going to be very difficult against Cage.
Cage going for his... Oh, no. Counter. Forearm right to the back of Cage's head. Oh. First DDT picked him up. Two. Nope. Can't quite get that three.
On the other side of things, Cage has taken a lot of damage so far in this match as well. You can see Kata is taking a second to get up.
Ooh, kicks Kata's foot out, and Kata's jaw runs right into his knee. Whoa! Spinning right hand. Throws Kata to the ropes. Oh, low down. That would have hurt.
And that's just our result. Cage can be. He didn't even get up to start that chain of offense. He stayed where he was. He kicked out Kata's leg. He brought him down to his level.
And you can see why Cage has been so successful. Cage trying to get the crowd behind him. It does not look like it's working.
No, it is not.
Cage doesn't care. He's having a good time.
Cage should be staying on Kata right now, though. I don't know if that distraction was worth it.
Cage put him up on the shoulders. Oh. Counter pin. Kata, one, two, and there's the kick. He's kicked out. Cage going for a body. Oh, no. Counter. Roll up. Kata, one, two, and he's out at two again.
Looks like his foot was on the ropes as well. And again, Cage is starting his offense from the ground.
Cage with the roll up. One, two, and the kick out at two.
Cage is so resourceful.
Pin one, two, and the kick out at two.
Cage is so resourceful, he barely has to get off of his feet to attack his opponent.
Front jawbreaker, and kick to the face from the ground. Cage has fought half this battle from the ground.
He's dangerous no matter where he is.
Kata catches the kick, spins him around, goes for the German, but Cage bounces off the ropes, holds it. Kata rolls backwards, and there's the counter. Cage all over him. There's another counter, going for the German suplex him. And a kick right to the face. Cage is down. One, two. Oh no, I thought it was a three. Cage gets his foot to the ropes.
The look on Kata's face says everything
Kata
right now.
Kata cannot believe it. That ring presence is a killer. Pulls the leg, goes for the pin. One, two, and there's the kick out at two. Wasted too much time.
Kata is an absolute disbelief. A German suplex followed by a super kick. And Cage is still in this somehow. Now we're gonna see some high risk, it looks like.
Kata going to the rep. It was high risk, all right, as Cage is always aware of where everything is in the ring.
A little trash talking for good measure. And those mean right hands.
And there goes Cage, off the turnbuckle from a headbutt. Kata gonna struggle to his feet here.
The top rope has not been kind to either of them so far.
But Cage immediately to his feet, and Kata knows better this time. Kata going for the orange soda right to the face. Kick to the head, Cage on the ground.
What do we call that? Is that an orange mist we just saw?
That was orange mist. Kata goes up. For the splash. Cage counter with the knees. He goes up, throws it. This one might be over. Two and three.
Kata put up one hell of a fight. Cage proved why he's been so successful. He lived up to his name. Now he's just adding insult to injury, dancing over the prone Kata. But Kata Murray was very, very impressive here tonight. He brought the fight to Cage. Just wasn't enough. I'm being told we're having some technical difficulties with the microphones. We have a technician right now trying to sort out. We apologize to the audience and to the very upset Matt Cage that it's taking this long. Unfortunately, technical difficulties are a very common part of independent wrestling. As you can see from the lights that are moving right now, that should not be. Ha ha!